So another option we have for a strangle or choke from the back, and this one's a little bit more of a choke because we're attacking the windpipe a little bit more, is the short choke. And so when we're trying to get a rear naked strangle, we're usually trying to get this hand as high as we can, our elbow as low as we can, crossing and finishing the choke. But from here, I need a lot of depth with this arm. And sometimes when somebody's fighting, that can be really hard to get, okay? Now, if somebody's chin is low, but I have that depth, I feel pretty comfortable putting the strangle on anyway. Their chin might pop out, it might stay in, but it's very uncomfortable, their carotids are still exposed, so I'm not really gonna stop my progression there. But if I get under the chin, right, and I can't get the depth, that's still enough, right? Like if I'm on top of the chin and I can't get depth, might be hard, right? I could try to crank them, but that's about it. But often we find ourselves in this situation where our arm is under the chin, but it's not all the way up and we can't get it all the way up, right? And any situation where you're feeling this, that's where the short choke really fits in. Okay? So what I'm gonna do is, I'm going to use my head to push my partner's head, and I'm going to connect a gable grip. And I'm going to fold the back of my elbow around his back, almost like the reverse of a high elbow guillotine. So shelving on the back. Okay. And what I want to do for this choke is I'm pushing with my elbow into his back as I'm pulling my other elbow across. So face back up. So any situation where I was fighting with him and I was able to get under the chin, but I don't feel like I can get any more depth out of the choke, I'm gonna connect my hands, shelf my elbow, and use it as a crowbar to push down so that I can pull back with my elbow and get nice pressure into his throat. Now remember that your head and your chest play a role too. My head's gonna push his head, and my chest is gonna push into his back. And this one, you see Marcelo Garcia uses this quite a bit.